Assalamu alaikum. Now, the last time I did a tutorial on the pattiala salwar suits, I've still got the videos, but I've not uploaded them. And one of the reasons for that is because I was in such a hurry and I had to give the suits. The suits went to a far distant country, Norway, and I've had a request to make two further salwars in pattiala salwars in a black and white. Now, I was not able to get white, pure white. This is a French crepe material which is in off-white color, and it's a beautiful color fabric which actually has a wonderful fold. So I've chosen to go for this. I'm not sure whether it's going to pass or not, but anyway, irrespective, I'm going to make this. So I'm just going to give you some, this is a 45 inch wide fabric, and what you want to do is cut a piece of two pieces of 34 inches, fold them over and place them equally. Now we're cutting across the table because we need a far bigger place, and otherwise it's not enough. Then where the double folded fabrics are at this end, I've marked off for the poncha, which I've done at approximately 7 inches, 7.5 inches. It's entirely up to you. And the bigger piece, I've folded it in double and I've just placed it here, and the length of this is approximately 38 inches a piece, and it's doubled, so it's folded over and back on itself. Now I haven't torn it from here. You can tear it away if you want. We're just going to cut along. This is just double folded and I'm going to cut. Now this is not cut on this is cut on the grain of the fabric, which is these edges where it has these little dotty bits and the threads don't come off. That is the grain of the fabric. So we're going to cut, and then here where the roller end is on that side, I've evened them out, so it's all one straight line. On this side we've got the one fabric overlapping the other, and it's overlapping by about 4 inches. So we've got an extra 4 inches here, and there's a gap here, and this is where, you know, I'm gonna do the crotch part on this side, and I've marked that as well. So 8 inches from this point over here, I've marked it down, and I've just left a little bit of a mark, and then it's just gonna be a straight line, which we need a fairly long ruler to do that. So I've taken this wooden plank piece and I place it on the two edges of my markings. So at that point I've got the crutch, at that point I've got the bottom opening, and I'm going to do a straight line all the way across, marking it out. Now we're going to be doing a few of these salwars because I'm doing a program. Well, it's a long story, and I'm going to do a video on that where you can get the full story, and hopefully I'm going to highlight and then put a program in as well on exactly what these outfits are going to be, those outfits are going to be made for. So these markings that I've marked, I'm just going to cut across. It's going to be just one long line, starting at the poncha part. And for one of these salwars, you're requiring, this is going to be a very heavy pattiala salwar, and normally the heavier they are, the nicer they look. But this is lightweight fabric, this is a beautiful fabric, this is one of the best fabrics that you can get for these salwars. So I'm going to be doing a cream one and black one, and I am going to give you a demonstration of it as well, hopefully. So once we've cut up to there, I'm just going to cut into here as well. And then, you know, it is just generally the cutting that's a little bit complicated, and obviously the pleating is a bit time consuming because there is really a lot of pleating. And that's the whole point of the pattiala salwar, that it is the heavy pleating that makes the salwar. Now this is the piece that's scrap, and what we do with this piece is we turn it around and we place it over here and we make sure that these pieces are absolutely spot on even. Now there may be a little bit extra on that, and I might just take that bit off. Now initially when I made these salwars, I had the girl, she phoned me up and she was a little bit worried, and I explained to her, because the salwar that I made initially, it sort of, the crotch area was a little bit tight, and I explained to her that one of the reasons why we tend to make those tight is because, actually what I might do is I might leave this for the back. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to angle this, and I'm going to use these two pieces just like we do in a trouser, so that we get the back of the crotch a little bit longer than the front. Generally I don't do that, but with this I'm going to do that. So okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to lay this, and I'm going to mark it out so that I can take a little bit off from here and just sort of like blend it in like this. I'm going to slightly define this one so that it's a little bit even more perfected. Since it's going to Norway, we want a perfect result. Okay, so that's going to be the two front pieces, and then we're just going to seam these along here. And once they're seamed, now the gear of this salwar is very wide. We've got, that's a yard and a half. So you've got approximately 3 yards, about 3.5 yards of width on this salwar. Yeah, approximately 3.5 yards of width. Now I've got to cut an exact same in black. Now I'm gonna, you know what, I'm gonna shape the belt part of this as well. I'll just tear off another piece and add it on. I'm gonna shape the belt as well, so that it's more. I'm going to add a couple of pieces there. I'll just add these just to give this a little bit more width.